नमस्कारम। वी ऑल हैव बीन यूजिंग टर्म्स लाइक सेप्सिस एंड सिवियर सेप्सिस, सिस्टमिक इन्फ्लेमेटरी रिस्पॉन्स सिंड्रोम और SIRS एंड सेप्टिक शॉक। बट ऑफ लेट टू ऑफ दीज टर्म्स, SIRS एंड सिवियर सेप्सिस, दे हैव बिकम ऑब्सोलीट एंड दिस हैज बीन प्रपोज्ड बाय द फिनिक्स क्राइटेरिया फॉर पीडियाट्रिक सेप्सिस। इट इज द इंटरनेशनल कंसेंसस क्राइटेरिया फॉर पीडियाट्रिक सेप्सिस एंड सेप्टिक शॉक, विच हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड लेटली in the month of January 2024. But prior to that, I would like to take a moment to thank every one of you who is a part of my endeavor for child health. This channel aims to keep you updated with the latest and to give you conceptual clarity, which is of utmost importance in achieving success in any medicinal field. What was the need actually? The most recent criteria which we have been using till date, specific to pediatric sepsis, was published in 2005 by the International Pediatric Sepsis Consensus Conference, but the problem was that it was based on expert opinion and so it wasn't very reliable. In 2016, the third International Consensus Definitions for Sepsis and Septic Shock defined sepsis as life-threatening organ dysfunction caused by a dysregulated host response to infection. But the problem with this definition was that it excluded children. It was mainly for adults. We know that pediatric and adult sepsis has important differences. These include age-specific variability of vital signs, developmental age-dependent immune function, and differences in pediatric-specific comorbidities, epidemiology, and outcomes. Considering the high morbidity and mortality in pediatric sepsis, there was a need for developing pediatric-specific criteria, and that too preferably evidence-based. Pediatric sepsis criteria applies to children younger than 18 years but are not applicable to the neonates whose post-conceptional age is younger than 37 weeks, that is, it is not applicable for preterm newborns. The former criteria, based on systemic inflammatory response syndrome or SIRS, should not be used to diagnose sepsis in children. So let me remind you what systemic inflammatory response syndrome criterion was. It is basically two of the following four criteria. If any two of the following four are abnormal, then it is referred to as SIRS. These include heart rate, respiratory rate, temperature, and WBC or neutrophil banding. So the heart rate cutoffs, age, according to the age, have been mentioned here. The respiratory rate cutoffs have been mentioned here. The temperature has been mentioned here, if it is less than 36 degrees centigrade or more than 38.5 degrees centigrade, and the WBC count cutoffs have also been mentioned over here. The former term severe sepsis. Severe word should no longer be used because sepsis in itself, it is a severe disease state. That is, it is a life-threatening organ dysfunction associated with infection, and therefore it is a severe disease state in itself. So how do you define acute organ dysfunction as per the previous criteria? Acute organ dysfunction was defined if there was one major organ dysfunction or at least two minor organ dysfunctions. So one major could have been respiratory or cardiovascular, any of the two, and two minor could have been two of renal, hematological, hepatic and CNS. So this was the criteria which had been in use till now. The new Phoenix sepsis score is a composite four organ system model including criteria for cardiovascular, respiratory, neurological and coagulation dysfunction. It is as follows. We'll be seeing this in detail. First system involved is respiratory system. The points which we need to assign are between 0 to 3 and 0 point if PF ratio is more than equal to 400 or SpO2 SF ratio more than equal to 292. 1 point if PF ratio is less than 400 on any respiratory support or SF ratio is less than 292 or any respiratory support. 2 points if PF ratio is between 100 to 200 and in invasive mechanical ventilation and SF ratio 148 to 220 and invasive mechanical ventilation. And 3 points if PF ratio is less than 300 and invasive mechanical ventilation or SF ratio less than 148 and invasive mechanical ventilation. Cardiovascular system has 6.0 to 6 points. 0 point if there is no vasoactive medication and lactate levels are less than 5 mmol per liter.
1 point each up to 3 has to be assigned if one vasoactive medication is being administered and lactate level is between 5 to 10.9 millimole per liter, along with the age-based mean arterial pressure range between being between 17 to 30 for less than 1 month age, 25 to 38 for 1 to 11 months of age, 31 to 43 for 1 to less than 2 years of age, 32 to 44 for 2 to less than 5 years of age, 36 to 48 for 5 to less than 12 years of age, and 38 to 51 for 12 to 17 years of age. 2 points have to be assigned for the cardiovascular system, maximum up to 6 for if more than equal to 2 vasoactive medications are being given, lactate levels are more than equal to 11 millimole per liter, and age-specific mean arterial blood pressure cutoffs are the following. The third organ system which needs to be assessed as per the PNIX criteria is the coagulation, and we need to assign 2 points, 0 to 2 points, platelets more than 1 lakh in INR less than equal to 1.3, D-dimer less than equal to 2 mg per liter, and fibrinogen more than equal to 100 mg per deciliter. All these are given 0 points. 1 point each, maximum 2 points for platelets less than 1 lakh per cubic millimeter, INR more than 1.3, D-dimer more than 2 mg per liter, and fibrinogen less than 100 mg per deciliter. And the last organ system which we need to assess is the neurological system, in which we give 0 to 2 points. No point if GCS is more than 10 and pupils are reactive. 1 point if GCS is less than equal to 10, and fixed pupils bilaterally are assigned 2 points. So as per the PHoenix sepsis criteria, sepsis will be defined if there is suspected infection and PHoenix sepsis score is more than equal to 2 points. And septic shock will be defined if there is sepsis with more than equal to 1 cardiovascular points. So this means that more than equal to 2 points means any one of these, this column, and more than one of this column, or maybe this column as well, and more than equal to 1 cardiovascular point, that is septic shock, will be defined in this manner. Not if this, but if this and if this is there. Children with sepsis who manifest organ dysfunction remote from the site of infection have a higher risk of death, suggesting life-threatening systemic processes. I know it is difficult to understand, but let me give you an example. Now, renal infection can occur either de novo, it is known as pyelonephritis. It can occur primarily within the kidney itself, or it can occur secondary to septicemia, which is occurring from somewhere else. For example, pneumonia leading to dissemination of bacteria in the bloodstream, which then infects the kidney secondarily. In either case, whether pyelonephritis is primary or secondary, renal dysfunction can occur. So this is an example of an organ dysfunction. It can occur at the site of infection, or it can occur remote from the site of infection. Like in the second example which I have shared, the primary site of infection is the lungs. But from the lungs, bacteremia and septicemia has occurred and kidneys have been involved secondarily. So, organ dysfunction can occur remote from the site of infection also. So, PHoenix has proposed a diagnostic flow to characterize patients using the new criteria for sepsis and septic shock. And this is the following. I shall be discussing this in detail as well. Now, suppose a child is unwell, you must screen for sepsis. If sepsis is suspected, then in that case you assess for organ dysfunction. And if PHoenix sepsis score is more than equal to 2, then you label the patient as having sepsis. If the PHoenix cardiovascular score is more than equal to 1, you label the patient as having septic shock. In an unwell child, and if while assessing for organ dysfunction, you must consider starting antimicrobial treatment and providing organ support as required. If a patient meets the criteria for sepsis shock, septic shock, or he meets the criteria for sepsis, then you must consider antimicrobials, organ support, and transfer to institutions with ICU facilities You must also adhere to best practices for quality improvement, enroll patients in clinical trials for research, and do disease surveillance and outcome monitoring for epidemiological purposes. If no sepsis is suspected and the Phoenix sepsis score is not more than equal to 2, or Phoenix cardiovascular score is not more than equal to 1, then also you must monitor and keep reassessing the patient and move to the initial part of the flowchart to screen for sepsis in case you have the slightest suspicion. The benefit of Phoenix criteria is that it can help in standardized data collection on epidemiology of disease globally and serve to support clinical care, quality improvement, benchmarking and research to improve outcomes for children with sepsis. This is a pediatric specific sepsis criteria. Certain future considerations are also there. Phoenix sepsis score could facilitate extraction procedures in electronic health records to identify children with sepsis across diverse settings all over the world. Just as some adult-based institutions use the sequential organ failure assessment score, that is SOFA score-based extraction procedures. The Phoenix sepsis score incorporated those sepsis-defining organ dysfunctions which are associated with increased risk of mortality, the four organ systems which we have discussed previously. Clinicians and researchers can identify and classify additional organ dysfunctions also, for example, kidney and hepatic dysfunction, using the Phoenix 8 score, with which the Phoenix sepsis score shares the same positive predictive value. So Phoenix sepsis score is basically for defining sepsis, but in case you want to consider more organ dysfunctions, you can use the Phoenix 8 score. The restriction to four organ systems only. What was the purpose of including only four organ systems? This was done to reduce the requirement for lab investigations and data collections in resource-limited settings. It is known that organ support such as mechanical ventilation or vasoactive medications may not be available in some low resource settings, in which case other score items such as low SF ratio, or even mean arterial blood pressure, simply they can be used to classify the cardiovascular score. The Phoenix criteria for sepsis and septic shock are intended to identify life-threatening organ dysfunction due to infection in children. They were not designed for screening the children at risk for developing sepsis or early identification of children with sepsis. So, institutionally available procedures to identify deteriorating patients with sepsis or infection should be followed for screening per se. There are certain limitations to the Phoenix criteria. It represents an oversimplification of the complex biological processes leading to sepsis in children. It has not attempted to characterize specific markers of dysregulated host response. Data from higher resource settings were derived exclusively from children's hospitals in the United States, so they may not be representative of children in other high resource countries. Death as a primary endpoint in children with infection does not account for infection-associated morbidity, and it does not include the long-term effects on children and their families. It has used a 24-hour presentation window in the development of criteria, which is a major limitation, because it excludes all children who developed sepsis as a result of healthcare-associated infections, which is a very important drawback. The temporal sequence of infection followed by organ dysfunction and death does not necessarily prove the causality. It does not prove that the organ dysfunction was due to sepsis only. The new criteria incorporated treatments delivered in response to sepsis, for example, vasoactive medications, and may not have accounted for other therapies, for example, sedation, which can also be influencing the organ dysfunction to some extent. And preterm neonates and term newborns who were hospitalized directly after birth were excluded from the study. So these pediatric sepsis criteria do not apply to these patients also. So there are major limitations to these criteria. Future directions involve independent validation of Phoenix sepsis score, especially in low resource, remote and mixed healthcare settings. Work is also required to ensure that such tools and criteria hold true across different age groups, especially newborns and preterms, And for patients with chronic conditions, congenital conditions and severe malnutrition, all of which are quite common in pediatric age group. The global challenges related to antimicrobial resistance demand testing efficacy and effectiveness of novel clinical and molecular markers that can reliably help deciding the targeted antimicrobial therapy. Thank you so very much for a very patient listening and watching, and just wanted to know, what do you think, is Finnick criteria more helpful than the one which we have been using till date? Whatever your response is, please do write in the comment section. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up, and thank you so much once again.